Hey guys, engineer versus researcher, what do these two roles consist of? What are the differences between the two and the pros and cons of each one? First, even if engineering is a science, there are several things that set it apart as a field. While doing research is doing science. Scientists observe the world while engineers focus on creating. While both fields do involve observation and analysis, engineering mainly deals with creating and working on already existing concepts, while scientists try to find out something new. Engineering is a much more specific field. Even though engineering deals with a variety of issues and topics, it's narrowed down to the study of how things work. Science has a much broader range of study. Science creates questions, while engineering creates solutions. Let's go into the detail as far as robotics is concerned. Robotics is particular because it's an interdisciplinary branch of both engineering and science. In fact, it includes mechanical engineering, electronic engineering, information engineering, computer science, and many other fields. So even if you are a researcher, you gotta have some engineering skills to put together already existing concepts and make things work before and or while experimenting new ideas. That's why the majority of roboticists from the current generation has an engineering degree. So the educational background of an engineer in robotics and of a researcher can be exactly the same, although they focus their efforts and improve their skills later on day by day during their career is gonna then make it clear what category they belong to. So let's consider an institute of technology or a research institute with a robotics department. Here we have both researchers and engineers, and this might also apply in companies, but it's not always said that they do have some research departments. So if we have a project about making a robot, the engineer might have to design and construct the robot using some already existing technologies or developing the firmware for the robot or for some sensors. Nothing new from a theoretical point of view. While the researcher might propose and try some new methods for the design of the robot, like for example the use of AI to generate aerodynamical shapes, or come up with new materials that can improve the performance or the robustness of the robot. So as far as the software is concerned, an engineer might have to develop a good control framework for the robot or implement some modules for making the robot do some specific demos by using state-of-the-art methods and provide technical support to the researcher that has to use the code to try new concepts and propose new methods to solve some specific limitations or problematics that have not been addressed so far. Among the main pros of the researcher, so there is surely the fact that they do not have to spend much time on developing some code or investing some effort in something that is basic and not really exciting. That's one of the cons of being an engineer. Also, the engineer doesn't have much freedom in what they do every day because they have to provide set technical support to the researchers and align with their necessities. Researchers instead are free to play around and try out new different ideas. The problem is when these ideas don't work, and even if you try hard, sometimes they just don't work and it can get frustrating and you gotta switch to other ideas or dig deep on some shit to make it work. So it can get stressing to make things work with no certainty about the validity of your methods and not much support available since they're new and you're probably the only one that knows better the technical details, you know. So there can be pressure to publish some research articles, and as an engineer instead you don't have to worry about publishing, and whatever you do has more or less been proved to work. And because writing papers can be very lame, especially when gathering tons of data and statistics and making plots. However, by publishing you can then attend conferences and meet so many peers, that's really exciting. You get to know and visit some cool places, and it's all at the expense of your institution. You can get holidays with a paid flight, that's pretty amazing. So far it seems that you can manage to keep the stress low. Being a researcher is more fun. Well, this fun comes at a cost. In fact, the salary of an engineer is generally higher than the one of the researcher. At IRIA, the institution where I work, in the first year of employment, the salary of a junior engineer is 20% higher than the one of a researcher, and as the years pass by, the salary of an engineer can potentially get to almost 40% more than a researcher. Well, these are the pros and cons of being an engineer versus being a researcher, so I hope that you got it and you have a clearer vision of the difference between the two. And see ya next time.
I hope you guys liked it. If so, hit the like button, subscribe, ring that bell so to know when more videos like this are out. It helps us out so much. I'll see you there.